at the church. 2 minutes drive.
Suppose I walk there now. What would you tell them? So simply tell them that you're trying to blackmail me into...
into?
Murdering your wife.
Until I found that everyone was looking at me.
Tony Lindis, finding his wife was having an affair, found the perfect opportunity to murder his wife for money.
Captain Lescate, con man and scoundrel, blackmailed into murder.
Margo Lindis and Mark Halliday, two lovers who share a not-so-secret affair.
Detective Hubbard, the one man who found Tony's little mistake.
Hubbard here. Look, O'Brien, he's found out about his key. Well, he came back just now and he couldn't get in. I think he's on his way to the station right now. Has the handbag arrived yet? Good. Okay, look. Give Wendis the handbag and make sure he sees the key. You might have to have him sign out and check the contents. If he asks about his raincoat or his key, just tell him that I'm in Union Square. Any questions? All right. Look, call me as soon as he leaves the station. All right. Well, Mr. Wendis, have you got it?
I don't think so. Where's Mrs. Wendis's key?
Well, I had already been suspecting, as I told you, Mrs. Wendis, that your husband had planned this murder. And after the investigation, I took it upon myself to find the key. It only took me a half an hour.
But if it were there, why didn't Wendis use it right now?
He didn't use it because he didn't realize it was there. He thinks it's still in his wife's handbag. You see, you were very nearly right. He told Les Gate that he'd leave your key up above the door and to put it back in the same place when he left. But when Les Gate was killed, he naturally assumed that it was still in his pocket. That was his little mistake. You see, Les Gate did exactly what you suggested, Mr. Halliday. He came in, put the key back, and then closed the door.
Out there the entire time. And the key that Wendis took out of Les Gate's pocket and returned to her handbag was
Les Gate's own latch key. Mind you, I didn't even get to that one at first. I thought your husband might have changed the locks or... You know, it just surprised me that he didn't have a latch key on him, you know. Usually a man has a latch key on him. But when I found the key, the notion struck me and I just escaped the address, put in the lock, and when I let myself in, I decided to borrow the phone and I called the station.
Why'd you bring me back here?
Because you're the only other person who could possibly have left the key outside. I had to find out if you knew it was there.
Suppose I had known.
But you didn't.
Mom?
Yes, darling?
Remember that breakdown you were talking about earlier?
What about it?
O'Brien. He did, okay, thanks. He just left the station. Try to hold on a little bit longer. Thompson.
Huh?
He's just off the station. Let me know if he comes this way.
That's fine.
Oh, and Thompson.
Huh?
In advance, please.
Yes, sir.
Mark, do you have a
handkerchief? What happens now?
Well, He's bound to come back sometime. As I pinch his key, he'll have to try the one in the handbag. And when that doesn't work, he'll realize his mistake, put two and two together, and look above the door.
But if he doesn't, and all this is pure guesswork, we can't prove anything.
That's perfectly true. Once he opens that door, we'll know everything.
What do you do then?
Well, I'm to phone the station, and they're waiting for my call.
And Mrs. Windis?
We'll have nothing else to fear. Thompson?
Sir, he has just turned the corner.
Right. Now is wait.
You got an idea, Regan?
Enough for sentimentals. Quiet, you two.
Garden. See the mess I made?
Shh.
He's coming back.
He's remembered.